50% of Americans are either diabetic or pre-diabetic. That is about 120 million of the population today. Diabetes is characterized by a chronic elevation of sugar in your blood, and it is most often caused by insulin resistance. This happens when you eat foods high in sugar and carbohydrates, and your body has to release insulin in order to bring your sugar levels down. The more it does this, the more your cells develop resistance to it, and the insulin that worked for your body before is no longer enough. We may not be able to control how our body releases insulin, but we can control the food that we eat. The number one thing to prevent is insulin resistance in our body. To do that, the number one thing and most important thing we can do to reverse the development of diabetes is limiting carbohydrates. What does this mean? Every single thing we eat is either characterized as a carb, a protein, or a fat. The relationship these three things have with the glucose in our body is very different. Carbohydrate being the number one thing that spikes our insulin, followed by a protein, and lastly, fats. The amount of carbohydrates we eat is the most detrimental to the amount of sugar spikes in our blood that therefore cause insulin resistance. Ways in which we can limit our carbs are avoiding all added sugar. Become accustomed to reading the labels on the products we buy. If it mentions anything about added sugar, this is definitely something you want to avoid. Sugar is so powerful, people say it's like it hides itself in some of the things that we eat. There are certain things that we eat that automatically contain sugar, like fruits for example. However, in moderation, this sugar is acceptable. What we don't want to do is drink something like apple juice that already contains natural sugars, but more sugars added by certain companies to make it more desirable. Added sugar is the number one thing that drives diabetes. Fructose and added sugar does not only increase the sugar level in your blood, but it can also cause fat to accumulate in your liver. This affects insulin resistance, the main cause of diabetes. If you were to drink 160 calories of sugar a day, which can be equivalent to a can of soda, you increase your chances of being diagnosed with diabetes by 1.1% every time. You should also avoid anything that says low-fat, fat-free, or light. That may sound healthy, but producers still have to make this product tasty and desirable to buy. Chances are, they have added sugars and carbs to this product instead. The idea is not to eliminate fats, but instead eat fats that are good for you. Fats found in olive oil, canola oil, or in fatty fish like salmon and tuna are known to be good fats. They can decrease the LDL, bad fats, or cholesterol in your body as well. You should also avoid packaged or processed food. You should be eating all natural foods even if they contain sugars, like fruits. The idea is that this is natural sugar and no artificial sugars are being added into the meal. Processed meats are heavy in salt and preservatives, and although they are not high in sugar, these things have also been linked to causing diabetes. These products also contain a very long list of harmful chemicals and preservatives that are unhealthy for anybody to consume. Barbecue sauce is an example of packaged sauce. Barbecue sauce is probably one of the worst packaged sauces you can consume. Just 2 tablespoons of the sauce will have you already at half of how much sugar you should be having in a day. Also, instead of drinking juice, eat the fruit instead. We know sometimes it is much easier and sometimes even tastier to drink a banana smoothie instead of eating a plain old banana. But what's the difference? By breaking down the fruit and blending it, we are also breaking down the fiber it contains. Also, when multiple fruits are made into a smoothie, it will most definitely cause a high blood sugar spike. We usually don't eat bananas, strawberries, grapes, kiwi, and apples in one sitting, but in a smoothie, we are. Another thing you can do is also switch from white bread and grains to brown rice instead. Even though brown rice still contains sugars, our body is able to process the sugar it contains much easier, which in turn decreases the amount our blood sugar spikes during that meal. Lastly, eliminate soda entirely. This has to be the worst thing a diabetic can have. Soda can have as much as 38 grams of sugar. You are pretty much taking spoonfuls of sugar when you drink a can of soda. Try drinking a sparkling or seltzer water with some lemon or lime. At first, the fact that it has no sugar will be hard to adjust to, but after a few drinks, you will enjoy the carbonated drink while also staying on top of your health. The most important thing a diabetic can do to reverse their diabetes is eliminating carbs to almost nothing. Contrary to popular belief, we don't need carbs in our diet. We can still follow a healthy diet by eliminating and limiting the amount of carbs we eat in order to stop the unhealthy cycle we put our bodies through. Carbs spike your sugar and also make you hungry so much faster, and therefore forces you to eat more carbs, and around the vicious cycle continues. These are just one of the ways we can reverse diabetes. If this video helped you in any way, make sure to subscribe and like our channel.